So with that, we'll probably get started. And talking about encryption in Office 365, it's not a very new term, because in general, we have a different set of encryption technologies that are already available. There is the standard transport DSL security, SSL security, which basically encrypts your tunnel information so that there's no snooping or eavesdropping attack. We also encrypt using BitLocker on the Office 365 data centers, make sure that nobody gets an unauthorized access. There's the concept of IRM, the information rights management, or as people probably remember it as rights management services, which will protect your documents, your libraries. You can attach the RMS templates or even create new templates if required, which will encrypt your message. And finally, there is S/MIME, which is a way to encrypt the data with the client certificates, very popular for the government scenarios. And all of these are available either today or will be available. I saw a question pop up for S/MIME. So S/MIME for Office 365 is actually coming this year. We have actually publicly talked about that, I think, late last year. And it'll be coming this year by Q1. So with all this encryption technologies already in place, why do we need message encryption? And the answer really is the scenario that we are trying to target here. Office 365 message encryption is targeted for scenarios which are more B2C focused. So you may have a bank which may want to send the banking statements to its customers. You may have a certain organization that wants to encrypt a message if something sensitive has been sent outside the company. Or you may have a healthcare organization that wants to protect their healthcare records or the patient information. All of them contain sensitive information. And the organization obviously wants to take that safeguard action of encrypting it, or at least protecting it to a certain extent. There's a very good article that I actually recently came across. It's actually written by one of Microsoft employees, which is on MSDN, which talks about how really something like this can be of great use to the healthcare industry. And I've included that link here for some of you who want to go and read it. I highly recommend it. It's a good link. And talks about how exactly Office 365 message encryption can be used. And that's the place that we talk about Office 365 message encryption. And these are the top four pillars, as I would call it, for our new offering. The first pillar being that the service allows you to send the encrypted mail to anyone. And by literally anyone, I mean anyone, because it doesn't matter what their recipient domain is. They could be on Gmail, they could be on Exchange, AOL, Yahoo, Squirrel, any of these email services. It doesn't really matter what their SMTP domain is, because we would still be able to send them the encrypted email, and all they need to have is a Microsoft account to log in and view their message. We also provide the capability of enhancing your organization's brand, because there are a lot of custom controls that you can place to further customize your message. And I'll talk about that in just a bit when we go through the different slides and talk about the features. There is a simplified administration. For those of you who are familiar with Exchange-hosted encryption, you would remember that while setting up the encryption rules, you had to take multiple actions. You had to detect a certain a header. And based on that header, you would say, okay, now encrypt the message. We have simplified that experience for the admins. And now it's a single click action. So there's a single action for encrypting the message. And at the same time, there's like a single action for decrypting. Just jogged in. Yep. Can you unmute? Thank you. Lastly, we also provide an easy to use experience for the users. The experience for the end users is pretty much like the Outlook web app that they are very much familiar with today. And that experience stays the same. And that continues on the other form factors where they may want to use this. There's no specific app for this about using the encrypted messages. But as long as your browser supports form post, they should be able to view the messages in the same manner like they do today on PC or the other machines. With that, let's talk about how it works, because I know there's something that is important to cover. So the best way to talk, you know, discuss how the new encryption works is to take a scenario. And here's a scenario that you probably are seeing now on your screen. And my organization here is Contoso Pharma, which is a pharmaceutical company. And they have a business requirement where they want to do two things. One, they want to first detect something sensitive being sent outside the organization. In this case, that happens to be a patient's medical record. And then once they detect that information, they want to take a next step further and encrypt that message so that doesn't matter who the recipient is, at least they're adding that second step of protecting the message with encryption. Coming to our actors in the scenario, we have two actors. The first one being Sanjay, who is one of the practitioners working for Contoso Pharma, and he's about to send an email that does contain some of that sensitive information to John, who is actually sitting outside Contoso Pharma organization, and we don't know who John is, and John could live on any of the other email services. We have to make sure that that message gets encrypted. So let's look at the different stages. There's different slides here or screenshots that will help you navigate through the process. The first thing that I'll do as an admin would be to go and create a rule that helps me depict the scenario. So setting up a rule is simple. What I'm doing here is I'm using the out-of-box capabilities of DLP to detect that there's something sensitive. In this case, that happens to be the healthcare legal information. And the second condition there is the recipient is located outside the organization. Now, based on these two conditions, if that matches, I have decided to do a couple of things here. One, I am doing a couple of DLP specific activities like notifying the user with policy step so that I'm educating him before he's about to send that message. And also I'm generating some sort of incident report just to make sure that I can keep a track of something sensitive being sent outside. But even more important action here is even if that email does get sent out, I'm taking that one step further by encrypting that message with Office 365 message encryption. And you can see that how simple it is within the action pane because it's a single action by encrypting the message with Office 365 message encryption. Previously, that would have required you a lot more work to set up that rule. Now, let's see with this condition, if that message does get sent out, let's say Sanjay drafts something, it has a patient record in it, it may be an attachment, it could be in the body of the message, and that message does get sent out. And our recipient here is John, who has a Hotmail account, and he will get the message in his inbox. And the message would look something like this. And you can see that that message contains some instructions at the bottom, which says, hey, to view your message, open the attachment and just follow the instructions. And at this point, he can open the attachment and follow the instructions. Point to be made here, the encrypted message is included as part of that attachment. So it's sitting in the recipient's inbox. We don't store it on the Exchange server or anything. It's with the recipient's inbox. When you click on the attachment, save it, open it up, you will see a new page which basically points you to this message, which says, hey, here's an encrypted message. And if you want to open it and view the message, simply click on the link. Two things to note here. You're seeing a couple of boxes highlighted, one of them being the Contoso Pharma Secure email portal at the top, and the next one being the Contoso Pharma logo at the bottom. So these are some of the new enhancements that we have added to Office 365 message encryption that allows the organization to add custom branding to their messages. And I'll talk about them in a bit going forward. Now, as a recipient, I can go ahead and click on the view your encrypted message, and that would allow me to see the messages in the plain text. What is going to happen behind the scenes is I'll get authenticated against my Microsoft account. In this case, John already had a Microsoft account, so he got authenticated and you're able to see the message. Now, let's say he's logging in for the first time and this address happens to be a yahoo.com address. In that case, we would ask you to create a Microsoft account using your yahoo.com email address. And that's a very easy step. We will also be publishing some documentation around it. There's already some documentation for what is Microsoft account that you can refer to. in case you're not aware of how that works. Once you can see the message, it's an easy to use experience because it's the same format or the same look and feel like the Outlook web app. And at this point, if you decide to reply to the message, your experience is exactly similar. So the way you see the controls pop up in Outlook web app, you're seeing that same experience here in the Office 365 message encryption as well. Another thing to point out here is that if this message does get sent or, you know, forwarded, or somebody tries to reply to it or does a reply all, even that message would be encrypted. So we are making sure that entire message and thread is encrypted, and the recipient does not need to have any sort of license to Office 365 message encryption to encrypt the message, because he can still continue to forward or reply. He doesn't need to have subscription as long as he doesn't go and changes any of the artifacts in the email. All right, with that, let's talk about some of the key features in Office 365 message encryption. And the first of them is the stronger integration that it provides with Exchange Transport Rules. I talked about how slightly difficult it was with Exchange Hosted Encryption, where you had to create a bunch of actions and detect a certain header within your message, and based on that you would take an action. For an admin, that experience is simplified, so you can straight away apply Office 365 message encryption using a single action. Or if you want to just remove the encryption from the inbound messages, you can do that as well. All of that is also possible through PowerShell as well, and I'll cover that in the next couple of slides. You can also see on the screen, it's sitting at the same place where we are also providing other security measures, such as applying the rights protection. So it's sitting in the same bucket within the Exchange Transport Rule of modifying the message security. The second feature that we like to talk about with Office 365 message encryption is the ability to customize your emails with your company's brand. And there are a couple of places where you can change the brand or, you know, make it adjustable as per your needs. This was actually one of our number one asks way back from our Exchange Hosted Encryption days. And we have heard back from the customers and made sure that we give this capability to them. So a couple of places that you would see this customization show up would be, number one would be around the header text. So if you see this message right now, you have a screenshot of the message, and it contains the attachment at the bottom you're seeing aligned with says encrypted messages from Contoso Pharma Secure Messaging System. Now you can change this to your organization's needs. You could say, if you're a banking organization, you can say this is from a banking portal or whatever. At least that gives you that first opening sentence of what that message is about and where is it coming from. There's also the capability of updating the disclaimer text that appears at the bottom of the message. You can change that to your organization's needs. It doesn't have to be, hey, Microsoft, it does not hold rights or whatever. You can change it to your organization, Contoso Pharma, blah, 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 whichever works out better for you. Disclaimer text is only shown on the first screen. When you go to the other screens where we actually see the message, we don't repeat the disclaimer for obvious reasons. But the first screen that you see here, you can update it based on your requirement. A couple of other places where we customize the email would be around the portal text. So at the top, when you see the encrypted message or when you're trying to sign in with your Microsoft account, you would see the secure email portal at the top, and you can change that to something that reflects more accurately what your organization is about. And lastly, at the bottom, you're also seeing the Contoso Pharma logo, which basically, again, is something that can be customized based on your organization's needs. And all of this is possible through PowerShell, and there are commandlets available that you can use to just update your records. I talked about the modern user experience, because that experience is very synonymous to the Outlook web app, and we are keeping that experience alike. So you don't have to have a custom UI like we had with the Exchange Hosted Encryption. The UI here is modern, and it uses the same functionalities and provides the same functionalities as are available to Outlook web app. I talked about that you can use PowerShell to configure Office 365 message encryption in different ways. And there are different commandlets that you can use to either create the actions for encryption or decryption. At the same time, you can use PowerShell to set or edit the different text or customizable components. In this case, that would be the different elements I showed to you, like the portal text, the logo, the disclaimer, and so on. There are different command lines that you can use to configure each of those elements, and they would be reflected immediately in your tenants. In terms of viewing messages elsewhere, if you're not using your PC, if you're using some different form factors, say it's a tablet or it's a machine or it's a phone, you can view the messages everywhere just like you do on your PC. The experience is also pretty similar because you would just log into your browser and you can see here's a screen which says, hey, here's a message with an attachment. I want to see the message. You'll open the attachment, then you will sign in with your Microsoft account and you can see that message in your mobile devices as well. Now, the key thing to point out here is that this is going to work as long as the browser supports the form postback. If your browser on your device does not support it, you'll have to download a browser or try a browser that actually does support it. But we don't officially provide an app on the encrypted messages because the experience is the same even if you're viewing it from a regular browser on your phone. A couple of things to touch upon in terms of the end user experience. The email experience, I talked about the UI, it's modern, it's with Office 365. So it's easier to navigate, there's a lot more real estate that you can play with. It's more pleasing to the eyes. In terms of security, for encrypting the message, we use RMS under the belt. So we are using our own technology to encrypt that message. So the key strength would be 256 SHA, if I may recall, and Tarek on the phone can correct me. But in terms of the rights assigned to the different audience or the recipients, only the co-recipient who's intended to view the message can see that message. But if he does decide to forward or reply to that message, even that message is protected. In terms of compatibility, we provide the same support as the Outlook web app. So whatever Outlook web app supports available with, same gets extended for Office 365 message encryption as well. For the admin, there is obviously the purchasing piece, which I'll cover in the next slide. In terms of configuring, it's a lot easier because there's easier actions to set up the encryption and decryption rules. And you can leverage the PowerShell commandlets to set up different branding elements. And also, he can manage the different usage patterns because it's built on top of Exchange Transport rules. You can definitely see the deeper granular reports through our Office 365 workbook that's available to download for the users. So all of this is available to the admins directly out of the box, and they should be able to leverage these capabilities. So let's talk about how do we purchase Office 365 message encryption. And for those of you who are previously familiar with the Exchange hosted encryption, we used to sell that as a standalone. But going forward, we are not doing that. We have decided to include Office 365 message encryption along with Windows Azure Rights Management, which also provides you the traditional capabilities of templates such as Do Not Forward or Company Confidential, which works great for an intra-company communication to protect your documents and your libraries and your messages. So including Office 365 message encryption as part of that same SKU gives you that capability of encrypting the message which are sent external to your organization. So it's a real the Windows Azure Rights Management basically now includes both the capabilities of internal and external, and we are not increasing the price of the SKU, that stays the same. So that stays at $2 per user per month. The good part there is because the Windows Azure Rights Management is already included with the Office 365 E3 and E4 suites, those customers will probably already start to see the Office 365 message encryption light up in their respective tenants, and they can simply start, they can just configure it and they can definitely start using it immediately. Having said that, the SKU is also available as an add-on. So if you are on any of the other plans that are listed on the left box, such as the Office 365 E1, K1, Exchange Online Plan 2, Plan 1, and so on, you can also use Windows Azure Rights Management, and that SKU can be purchased for $2 per user per month. That's the US price. There's also the possibility of using this solution if you're an on-prem customer. The only criteria there is that you have to route your emails through Exchange Online, so you can purchase either Exchange Online Protection, which gives you the capability of protecting your messages against spam and malware, or you can set up a hybrid mail flow that allows you to send your messages through Exchange Online. But all in all, it would work in either of those scenarios. There are you have to follow those steps, but you can definitely leverage Office 365 message encryption that way. A couple of things to point out. Windows Azure Rights Management is not available with Office 365 small business plans, so they will not be able to use the Office 365 message encryption features yet. All right, so what does this packaging mean? And here's a before and after if you're aware of EHE, or if you're, even if you're not, I think the slides kind of helps you get that picture of what was happening earlier and what's going to happen going forward. So for the customers who were already on the E3 plan or E4, or they had a subscription to Windows Azure Rights Management, they were paying the standard $2 SKU for Windows Azure Rights Management, and they were paying another $1.87 for Exchange Hosted Encryption. But going forward, we would include them together without raising the price. And by purchasing Windows Azure Rights Management for that same $2 SKU, you get both those capabilities together. And if you are a standalone customer, when I mean that, I mean the on-prem customer who does not have a Windows Azure Rights Management, and you also don't have Exchange Online Protection, meaning you don't have a way to route your emails to Exchange Online, the situation would was pretty similar, because you were purchasing EOP earlier for $1 per user per month, and also EHE for $1.87. Going forward, you would still purchase EOP because you want your emails to be routed through Exchange Online, but instead of EHE, you would purchase Windows Azure Rights Management, which also gives you the RMS capabilities along with Office 365 message encryption. In terms of the channels where you can purchase the Office 365 message encryption through Windows Azure Rights Management, you can purchase it directly from Microsoft, or from an advisor partner, or from the enterprise agreement. It's not available for purchase through Select Plus, Syndication, and Splaw partners, and also through Office Value and Office 365 open subscriptions. So these are all already documented. It's not changed, but just a reminder for those of you who are not aware of Windows Azure Rights Management or are not available of how that's available. So what's going to happen to the customers who are already using EHE, who are on EHE, they are using EHE today? We will be upgrading you to Office 365 message encryption. Point to be made here, it's an upgrade because we are adding a whole new bunch of features to your current experience, simplifying your experience both if you're an admin or if you're going to be an end user, that enhances your experiences. And upgrade to the new message encryption has already started, and customers who have not yet moved, they will be upgraded to Exchange Hosted Encryption, and we will not be obviously charging anything. They'll be upgraded at no additional cost. They will be sent an awareness and the upgrade emails well in advance of their upgrade date. So they'll be told of, hey, this is coming and this is what you need to expect. There's no action required from the tenant admins. We will take care of all their existing EHE policies. We'll make sure that they are automatically migrated to the Office 365 message encryption. We'll set up the new rules and make sure that their experience is not impacted. They would continue to have access to their old messages, which were encrypted with Exchange Hosted Encryption, but we will not be upgrading the old EHE messages to Office 365 message encryption. But any new messages that they do send out, they will be encrypted with Office 365 message encryption. And here's a sample upgrade communication. This is how it will look like. It's just a draft, but this will give them, you know, the heads up of, hey, this is, your upgrade is coming. It'll also point them to the EHE Upgrade Center, which has been set up now on TechNet. It's been there for a while now. And these communications will follow in a cycle. So we'll start with T-minus 30. There'll be a T-minus 15. There'll be a, you know, the transition, or rather the upgrade communication. And finally, even after the post-upgrade, we will send out some communication on how best they can start using Office 365 message encryption. So all of them would follow through a regular process for Office 365 message encryption. Talking about the feature comparison for EHE versus Office 365 message encryption, here are some of the items that we have called out. So you could send encrypted mail to anyone in both, but some of the key differences or advantages with Office 365 message encryption include the increased message size limit, which is now 25 MB. On top of, it used to be 10 MB for Exchange hosted encryption. The integration with Exchange transport rules is a lot simplified, and you can take single actions. So whereas for EHE, it used to involve complex headers. You can integrate with DLP just like you used to do with EHE. An example as well, where I talked about how I used DLP in combination with encryption for detecting the healthcare record. And that's great because that combines the synergy of the two products and how both DLP and encryption can come together. One of the most key, very important element for Office 365 message encryption is the branding. And that's a totally new capability that wasn't available with EHE. The end user experience also is much enhanced. Instead of using a custom EHE portal, we leverage the same UI, modern UI like Office 365, and keep that experience same and anonymous as Outlook Web App. And lastly, instead of selling this SAN standalone, we are offering it as part of Windows Azure Rights Management, and we're not raising the price again. So that gives you the complete protection for your external communications. So towards the end of the slides, a couple of resources that you should be aware of, and you should refer to it if you haven't already. You can go ahead and purchase Office 365 message encryption. Because it's included with the Windows Azure Rights Management, you can go to the Windows Azure Rights Management page, and you can buy the product there, or you can simply try it for a certain duration. I believe the duration is 90 days for the trial, and you can definitely do that, 90 or 30, one of them. But you can definitely go ahead and purchase the product through the Office commercial page, and you're seeing a screenshot of that as well. We have also set up a Office 365 message encryption marketing page, which talks about some of the key features and why you should use Office 365 message encryption. And finally, there's also product documentation along with videos available on TechNet, and you can refer to them as well to know more. For those of you who are going to be upgraded from EHE to Office 365 message encryption, there is an EHE upgrade center, and here's a short URL that you can refer to. That is www.getencryption.com, and that will take you to the EHE upgrade center. Now, there are quite a few folks internally from Microsoft also on this call. So just for them, this is only for them, but not for the external audience. There are some internal resources that you could use. So there's an internal upgrade center that has been set up, and there are a couple of DLs for feedback, or if you have any feature requests, you can reach out to ehefeedback@microsoft.com. Or if you have any questions around the upgrade, you can also reach out to ehupgrade@microsoft.com. So that's only for the internal people on the Microsoft side who are on the call today. That brings us pretty much to the end of the presentation, and I'm open to take any questions from the audience. I see there are a lot of questions already, and thanks, Tarek, Curtis, and people on the call for answering, but let's take more questions as we see them.